morning, Merle. Lovely day, isn't it?
If by lovely you mean cold and lonely. Pornography, I'll keep you company up at your cabin. Oh, I sure do miss my wife.
Morning.
Morning. How did you find me? No! Ah! Gotcha! I knew you'd come eventually. And when you did, I'd be ready. You messed with me for too long, Mr. Pickles. This ends today.
Lay down, old boy, put your head down.
Don't play cute with me. Why do you think I bought a cabin in the middle of nowhere? So I could kill you and no one would ever find out about it. Now, any last words? Of course not. You're just a dumb dog.
I may be a dog, Grandpa, but I'm not dumb.
Yeah, you are. Look who's in the cage. You could talk all of a sudden?
Nah, I always could. But I only whip it out on special occasions.
What? I knew you were evil, but I always thought you were still just a dog. How can you talk?
Let me out of this cage, and I'll tell you everything inside. It's cold out here. Brr.
I'm not stupid. I don't care if you can talk. I'm gonna kill you anyway.
All right. Then I guess you'll never know why I'm evil.
Now, tell me why you're evil.
Well, it all started a long, long time ago. In the lost city of the Papanatra Faganatharaks, the ancient ones would sacrifice a dog to appease the gods. But on this particular day, something unexpected happened.
Huh? Merle, what are you doing here?
Well, with the cold and the recent passing of my wife, I thought you might entertain the idea of some company. I could use a good cuddle.
What? Sorry, I'm kind of in the middle of something.
Nothing sexual. Just lie by the fire, hold me tight, and tell me everything's gonna be all right.
No, I'm not gonna cuddle with you. I'm busy. Yeah. Hey!
You're gonna cuddle me good.
What? Hey, what are you doing, Mr. Pickles?
Oh, I'm sorry. Did you want to cuddle with him or not?
Wait, did that dog just pop?
Now, Grandpa. Did you want me to finish my story? Or should I just get to the part where I kill you? Think you can make it all the way to your truck, old man?
I told you I was ready for you.